Alaikum class. This is my ninth lesson, and in this lesson I will give you introduction about the bar graph. In the previous lesson we learned about the graph. What is the graph? In mathematics we can define the graph as a pictorial representation or the diagram that represents the data or values in an organized manner. So the question is, what is the bar graph? A bar chart or the bar graph is a chart or a graph that represents a categorical data with the rectangular bars with the heights or lengths proportional to the values that they represent. The bars can be plotted vertically or horizontally. A vertical bar chart is sometimes called the column chart. Now let's have a look on an example of the bar chart, how it look like. You can see here towards the y-axis they have mentioned the million of the profits, and here in the x-axis they mentioned the years, and they have the some heights and widths. So as we have in the next x-axis and y-axis, and when we will put some values on it, they look like this. This is the positive values of x-axis, and these are the negative values of x-axis. These are the positive values of y-axis, and these are the negative values of y-axis. So let's have an example of the bar graph. Here they has given us the shoe size and the frequency of the shoe size. Like how many times, or what is the frequency of the 38 shoe size or 39 shoe size and so on. And similarly, I will take the frequency towards the y-axis and the shoe size towards the x-axis. And I have to see what is the frequency of 38 size. The frequency of 38 size is 6. I will just draw a vertical bar. I draw a bar on 38 size. And now I have to see what is the frequency of 39 size. And similarly, I will put here a bar on the 39 size. I have to see what is the frequency of the 40 size. This is the frequency. 3 is the frequency of the 40 size, and I will put, I will draw a bar till 3. And similarly for the 41 and for the 42. And you guys can see in the previous lesson we just draw a single line and the straight lines. There was a line graph by joining the dots, and this is the bar graph because we are just giving some height or the length or the width to them. Now I'm moving towards example number 2, that is related to the bar graph. Here is the number of the students and their favorite fruits. We have to see what is the higher frequency or the higher number of the students are 10. So we will write till 10, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and till 10. We have to see what how many students like the apple. Five students like apple. Five students like apple. I will draw the bar to till 5, and I have to see how many students like grapes. And 6 students like grapes. I draw the bar on grapes till 6, and similarly I draw a bar on the oranges till 10, because 10 students like the oranges. And I have to see how many students like the guava, and the 8 students like the guava, and similarly for the strawberries. And similarly, when the data is given to you guys and this is to you, you have to just show this data through line graph or the bar graph. I hope you guys can do it. Thank you.